We've got dark skies out and a few showers right now. Let's go to Doppler radar where we start in a couple of lightning bolts, and we've got some heavier downpours, mainly in River Parish's North Shore. Rain that's just offshore to around Gentilly and Lakefront. That's the only one affecting the potentially greater New Orleans area. So there you see Doppler radar, a couple of sprinkles, maybe even from lower 9th, going up to the high rise in UNO. Just off in Lakefront Airport's just been some sprinkles here too. A little farther out, do have some showers and downpours still out. The Bonnie Carey from La Branch here. Frenier and Laplace got some heavier downpours and fading showers now once we had some rain that we can see this continue to develop. And Kramer to Choctaw, Bayou Buff, and Russo's getting some showers. Other than that, I've got some isolated showers on the parish borders in the North Shore. Let's go to Tangipahoa and the heavier downpours now to the northern part of the parish. We're looking Lewiston, Bolivar, and even Holton, Roseland, Fluker, Tangipahoa, where we've got the rain. That kind of covers the rain right now to what we had. And this was that 30% chance we discussed yesterday at this time. 87 officially in town, but Bogalusa is still running a 94. Let's show you the front, where that is. Let's track it and time it. What it means for rain chances, the likeliest rain chance, most widespread rain chance too across southeast Louisiana we've had in some time. Yes, those were tornado and severe thunderstorm watches northwest, but the front should ease in Wednesday, come through overnight Wednesday to Thursday, but then a little cooler air is going to drop in behind. So rain the next 2 days will require that you got your umbrellas or some rain gear the next two. So the development of storms tomorrow, this forecast shows heat of the day by about 11 to 1. By the heat of the day in the afternoon, let's go scattered storms ahead of the front. Didn't show much along the coast. Did show storms off and on I-10, I-12 corridor north. Still some storms by about 7. The sun sets and we start to get a break. And there's a chance these storms popping up tomorrow can provide some strong wind gust potential, a level 1 out of 5 category. Marginal risk, but it's a very low-level threat. Also, some locally heavy rain, a level 1 out of 4 categories, also a marginal threat. We're just thinking it's more run-of-the-mill thunderstorms, nothing too big for us, and it shouldn't be storms after another, 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 and a flooding potential. Top temps to 92, compare that to the average high of 87, so we're a little bit above. Thursday morning shows quite a bit of storm activity. It's just one forecast. Do think that we could have a likelier storm chance if we heat the afternoon through the clouds and the actual fronts through. So let's go with a 60% chance of storms tomorrow, coming in Wednesday night, and then going to Thursday and maybe some lingering showers to the coast on Friday. But look at the temperatures dropping to the 80s. If we have clouds in Thursday all day long, I could hold those top temps to maybe only 85. Some sunshine even on Friday, though, but the temperature's still below 90 for highs, and we're going to realize the cooler, drier air as we go to the weekend. But through the weekend into next week, we'll return some warmth. Not sold on this system dropping in from the east. We'll monitor that one. But the tropics, there are no concerns with Hurricane Gabrielle. Still a Category 4. We'll weaken to a 3, and that's going to go east all the way, cross over the pond, and then impact, it looks to be, Portugal and Spain by next weekend. So we're looking locally now, invests 94 and 93L. It's a medium chance over the next 3 to 7 days with a leading wave and a high risk, a 90% chance over that secondary wave. When you look at the forecast information out of this, I'm really not sold that there's much out of them. That secondary wave could be our next named storm, looks to be the strongest, taking a Gabrielle course. The leading wave looks to possibly go to the mid-Atlantic and the East Coast, but even then, it combines with another storm and it's not a concern. Nothing for us. That's the takeaway. 7-day forecast. Front eases in tomorrow. Look at those temperatures behind a Thursday, Friday. Been a long time since we've been in the 80s for highs.